हे गाइस, वेलकम टू प्रैक्टिकल फिश टॉक। इफ यू आस्क मी विच इज माई फेवरेट फिश, आई एम डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू से एंजल्स। एंजल फिश, आफ्टर सीइंग दिस फिश आई स्टार्टेड माई हॉबी बैक इन 2004 or 5। आफ्टर सीइंग एंजल फिश आई स्टार्टेड हैविंग एंजल फिश एंड गोल्ड फिश इन द सेम टैंक। इवन नाउ आई हैव द सेम कॉम्बिनेशन। It's been 15 years, I've been learning a lot of things about too many fishes. Angelfish is one of them. So I've learned a lot of things about angelfish, how to take care, how to raise them, what are the things they would require. Angelfish are very hardy fish, not like other people have this perception about angelfish that they are very soft. No, they are not soft. They are hardy fish. They are basically tropical fish, which means the water temperature has to be slightly on warmer side, which is somewhere from 75 to 82. If you keep at 77 or 78, it is all fine. These fish are not difficult to keep. These are very hardy and very friendly. If you see, if I just keep my hand here, all the fishes will come and, you know, they just want some attention from the owner. So they are very friendly fish. I would really recommend you to start with angel fish, but don't forget to cycle your aquarium before adding any fish. If you want to know how to cycle your aquarium new tank instantly, then I'm giving the link on top. You can go and check there. I've explained how to cycle an aquarium instantly. Within few hours or one day, you can start adding your fish into the aquarium. Angelfish are basically omnivores, which basically means they eat both vegetables as well as some worms, insects, or even if it is very small fish, then they are going to attack and eat them. So you'll have to take care, you'll have to keep a tab on which fish you are going to add into a community tank where angelfish is there. Because if the fish is very small, which will fit into angelfish's mouth, then definitely they are going to eat them. Today we are going to see which are the top 7 things which we have to know to take care of angelfish. Without wasting any time, let's see how to do it. If you are new to this hobby and if you want to have angelfish in your tanks, then you'll have to understand something. These fish grows vertically. These fish doesn't grow horizontally. So it is always best and it is must to have taller tanks. So bigger the aquarium, it is always best for angelfish, because these are going to grow very fast based on the food you are going to feed them and the space available to swim. So always remember, always buy a bigger tank, a taller tank. Angelfish are not very powerful swimmers like any other fish which will tolerate the strong current of your power filter. Angelfish likes the slow current. Like in Amazons, these fishes will live in flooded ponds or some rivers which have very slow current. So basically we have to copy the same nature, same atmosphere into the aquarium. We will have to provide very slow current which will comfort the fish, and which will not stress your fish. Normally if you have a power filter inside your aquarium, its flow will be very powerful and which will not be tolerated by angelfish. Ultimately your angelfish will be stressed and someday it will attract some diseases or die all of a sudden. So it is always best to keep the flow very slow. If you have a power filter, then you'll have to think about changing it. If the aquarium is too huge, then it's okay, power filter will work. Keep the current very slow. Or if you don't have a power filter, if you have an external filter, then that works best. It is not compulsory to keep plants in your aquarium where you have angelfish, where you have only angelfish. But if you have a community tank, if you are thinking to add more variety of fish apart from angelfish, then adding plants is a must. Because there will be too many kinds of fish, and if there is some aggression problem, then fish can go and hide between the plants. So it is always recommended to have plants if it is a community tank, or if you are keeping only angelfish in the tank, then you don't have to keep any plants. Talking about plants, Amazon Spot is the best plant for angelfish. because the leaves will be wider and longer, so it will help the fish to go and hide and swim through. It is a really good plant. Even for breeding purpose, these plants are really helpful. Also, aggression is quite common in angelfish tank because they are highly territorial and they are not going to kill each other, but they are just, they will just try to protect their territory. So if there is aggression problem in your angelfish tank, then don't worry. They are not going to kill each other. They are just, protecting their territory. Even in my aquarium, there is aggression problem, but it is not killing aggression. It is just an aggression for their own territory purpose. This is really interesting topic, tank mates of angelfish. If you want to know, I'm not going to talk about which are the tank mates which suits angelfish to live in the same tank. I'm going to give the link somewhere here on top. So you can go and check there which are the tank mates which are available in India. Basically, which are easily available in India. So be very cautious while choosing tank mates. Any fish it might be, if it is very small which will fit into angelfish's mouth, then they are going to become food if you add such tiny fish into the aquarium. As I already explained you in the initial part of the video, that angelfish is going to grow up to 6 inches tall. So keep in mind, angelfish are fast growing and they are going to thrive if the population is less. If the place to swim around is more, your angelfish is going to live very happily. So the math is, for every 20 gallons, one angelfish can be kept. But I normally keep one angelfish for every 10 gallons. So based on the size also, I normally keep 3 to 4 inches big. If the fish is 5 to 6 inches, then definitely for 20 gallons, one fish can be kept. Also, these are very fast growing, so you'll have to keep a tab on how many fishes you are going to keep in your tank. If your tank is very big, then it is well and good. You can keep smaller fish also, because they are going to grow anyway after a few months or a year. So keep a check on population. Don't overpopulate your aquarium, because if you overpopulate, then aggression problem will be there and water quality will reduce. All these problems will arise. So always keep in mind, don't overpopulate your tank. For every 10 gallon, one fish can be kept. Angelfish are similar to discus fish when it comes to water parameters and breeding. So angelfish or discus fish likes to swim in clean water. They always go in search of clean water in Amazon rivers. So it is always best, it is always recommended to change 30% water every week. Or if you don't want to change water every week, then if you don't have time, then once in 2 weeks you can change 50% water. It is always best practice to change every week so that your fish thrives in clean water. If you are into breeding, then you'll have to change water more frequently, like once in 2 days or once in 3 days. If you are not into breeding, then changing once in a week is always best practice. There are few people who ask me whether they can keep a very small angelfish with a bigger angelfish. I would definitely say no. If you are trying to keep 1-inch angelfish with 4 or 5-inch angelfish, then it is going to be a huge disaster. Bigger angelfish is going to attack and create a lot of stress on smaller angelfish. Because of stress, again, lot of diseases, most importantly white spots will be seen immediately on smaller fish because of the stress created. If you are adding some other variety of community fish which is compatible with angelfish, if it is slightly smaller, then it is well, it is good, it is fine. But don't add very small angelfish with bigger angelfish. For example, don't add 1 or 1.5 inch angelfish with 4 or 5 inch angelfish. So that is not going to work. Always keep in mind, add similar sized angelfish in the tank. Keeping angelfish is that simple. Just have some knowledge, basic knowledge about angelfish and what are the water parameters and what are the basic things which you have to follow. I think this video was helpful for you guys. If you really like this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next video, bye bye.